Welcome at this presentation, where I will tell you about the need for software structuring. My name is Ilko van der Wol and I'm the Managing Director of the organization called PLC Open. PLC Open is a mature organization active in the industrial control software. And as such, it has delivered over the years many items. Basically, PLC Open merges logic, motion, and safety into one development environment, providing you one tool to manage your application development. And that delivers more efficiency in automation via structuring, decomposition, reuse, and less training. On top of that, PLC Open added Exchange via XML, communication via OPC UA, and training guidelines and papers on this. Let us look a little bit back in time. This is a plain old telephone system. I'm not even sure if you recognize this one. I'm not even sure if you have used those. Because nowadays, a phone looks like this. A smartphone including many apps that helps you to do more than just telephone. This is the first mass-produced car, Ford Model T. Nowadays, a mass model car looks like this. There's a huge difference. And if you look to the production lines of these cars, you see that originally with the T-Ford, there was much manual labor involved. And nowadays, we all know that most of the jobs are done with robots to provide a consistent quality in the production in that sense. Now, what has changed in all these aspects? It's the role of software. If you look to the phone, the product differentiation is in the different apps that you put on your phone. The hardware can be the same, however you provide different functionalities to it. And for you, it is your own phone, a different phone. And without the software, the phone is useless. It's a piece of hardware, a piece of weight. This is a Tesla car. Tesla can increase the efficiency of its batteries, increase the safety, increase the comfort, all via software update. That is why you can call this car software on wheels. And in principle, everybody can make robots. It's not that difficult. The essential part on this is who can make them cooperate, who can take care it produces that what you want in the right quality and in the right efficiency. Industrial automation is based on software. And software comes with several problems, and I will show you some of them. Let's first look to the hardware where software runs on. We know this Moore law. Something doubles every 18 months. It used to be the number of transistors on a chip, but it also can nowadays be the storage on your hard drive or the speed over your network. Now, this had effect on the software. We could run more code, lines of code, so the volume increased. The usage increased. You saw popping up software and chips everywhere. It's increased in its usage, in complexity, and our dependency on it. We really need the software. An office without software, we cannot imagine that one. A phone without software, we cannot imagine that one. A car without software. But there's a problem to this. We need this more and more. However, the efficiency in the software development is not according to Moore's law. There is no doubling of the lines of code that anybody develops every 18 months. It's more a flat line. So we are more dependent on software. However, there's an additional problem with this. The complexity increases exponentially. So you double the lines of code and you more than double the complexity. That means that software development is about managing this complexity. And this is where PLC Open plays its role. You see, because of these software issues, that if we look to a production system or a production line, you see that the content of the development cost is ever increasing. This picture goes to 2000. Nowadays in 2020, it's even worse than this. Yeah? So how do we deal with this? How do we deal with all these complexities? How do we deal with these typical software problems? First of all, you use modern software development tools. On top of that one, you use libraries of reusable components. Open standardized interfaces help there. And you create an application program that's independent from the hardware and underlying architecture, so make it more reusable and makes it better understandable for the different people that work on this. Keywords for the modern software development process are structuring, decomposition, reuse, encapsulation, and abstraction. And with structuring, I mean that you decompose your problem in that sense to sequences, steps. So within IEC 61131, there is a structuring tool called sequential function chart for this. And you see that this is a loop where you do you execute a process and you know how it continues in that sense. So you identify all the sequences, all the different steps. And of course you do that including the error behavior and the aborting situation. Normally the normal behavior is simple. It's the exceptions that has where you need to invest your time. You have to have your focus on. So if you look to decomposition, if I have a car, it can have an engine, and an engine contains pistons, and the pistons are linked to a crankshaft that is turning around on this part. So this is a decomposition in that sense. And if you take that one step further, you will see that if we want to move from A to B, we need a car, and a car has this motor, it has a steering wheel, and it has tires in that sense. And I can decompose that further and further till I get to a level where I can identify reusable components. And when I have those, these building blocks, I can link them again, combine them, and fill in these different levels, and in the end, solve the problem we have. So provide a solution. And that means with this decomposition and reuse, your application program calls all of these function blocks, these high-level building blocks. It's like a Lego system in that, or a jigsaw puzzle. So your application program itself is small in the end, and it calls these building blocks, these reusable components that we identified. And we put those in function block libraries. Yeah? And Peel Schoppen has made many of these function block libraries in logic, for motion, for safety, and for communication. And you can use these libraries as the basic blocks to create your application. So if I look to a machine, there are several layers in that. On the bottom, on the base, we use these basic libraries. And we'll build on them, we create our own libraries. So you create your own libraries, which are much more specific to your application and much more fulfill the specifics that are in there. And Peel Schoppen has defined guidelines how to create the libraries on all the levels shown here. And then we get to the application program, which again calls these underlying structures. So calls these building blocks that you created in your own application-oriented libraries. And so the application program is small again, and it uses the underlying technology. And we always advise to put a state machine on top of your application program, so on top of your machine, because it gives you a harmonized look and feel to your machines. And if you use this on the different machines, the same state machine, all the machines look and feel the same. So that's very easy in your handling of them on the production floor. So if we compare this methodology to methodologies or usages that you see many cases in the field, the copy-paste modify is probably the most expensive to deal with. Yeah? Somebody said, I think we did that in the past. Let me look to that one. And then they start copying that one. They start modifying that one. And without knowing the good structure, the documentation. So if somebody else looks at a later stage to this application part of the program, then he will notice that there is no link between these changes and what's really happened there. So in the end, in the long term, over the life cycle of a machine, this is very expensive. It can be that it looks like an efficient way. In the end, it's not. And this is where PeelShopen comes in. Yeah? As an organization, we want to provide efficiency in automation. And when we say automation, we mean industrial automation, production processes, machine building. PeelShopen is a worldwide organization. Its main office is in Europe, and we have supporting offices in North America, in China, in Japan, and in Korea. As an organization, we have technical committees and promotional committees for the different regions and for the different aspects that we work on. And that is supported by the members in the general meeting, the board of management on a more regular basis, and the managing director, and that's my position. So PeelShopen brings a suite of specifications covering the different areas, and we all fit this in a total concept to make it more efficient for you in that perspective. If you want more information on specifics, check our website in this case. You can subscribe to an electronic magazine that updates you the information on a regular basis. And if you want to reach me, this is my email address. So thanks for watching. There are more movies available on the different topics, and there are more to come. So stay in contact with us, and I hope you enjoyed this part. Thank you. Bye for now.